Hey there, ho there, ladies and gentlebeans, and welcome to another exciting episode of Let's Play Transformers Devastation. In the previous episode, we were introduced to the classic Autobots, or at least some of them, and their non-stop waging war to destroy the evil forces of the Decepticon. Here we've got the mighty Optimus Prime, standing mightily as the sun glares over there. I can't center this because it's one of those games that uses the over-the-shoulder view, but whatever. So we've been playing as him for this first chapter, and I think we're about halfway through it. We have to basically find a way to disable the security system of the giant fortress that sprouted out of the ground that Megatron has gone into. He's got some nasty plans, and he wants to do things to the planet, so we're gonna go and quickly retreat into the Ark and see if we can do a little bit of upgrading, because I showed off some of the light RPG mechanics here, but not all of them, so why not start that off with that here? Because, you know, that makes all the sense. So, what do we got here? We've talked about tech, sort of. We haven't talked about developing the tech, but we have talked about equipping it. So why don't we develop a piece of tech here with our old buddy Wheeljack? Just like everything else, you use currency to make it, and you can either have some really... you can either have a chance to make something really common, or a chance to make something really good, which, you know, depending on what you want and how much money you have. We've got plenty of money, though, so we're going to invest 5,000 credits and try to make something good. Gotta line up that bar in the right place, which we just...
Legendary.
Ooh, ally heal, 10%, and ultimate move attack up, 15%. That's pretty cool. But let's see if we can get something else. Zoop, zoop.
It'll work.
Oh, I got something simple. Vehicle speed. I don't want that.
Right. Got it.
Come on, Wheeljack, you're more of a genius inventor than that. Ooh, a red one. Is that good? I forget if the orange one is good or not. We're going to...
Sometimes I impress myself.
It is! It's an excellent! Ooh, knockdown defense 30, damage down 20. Oh, damage down 2. That's a really good defensive chip. I might actually stick that on Optimus. Whoop.
Something went wrong.
Now acceleration up, that's not too bad.
Got it.
Whoop, 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 whoop.
This is legendary.
Ooh, excellent. Rush attack up 10%. I wouldn't necessarily call that legendary, but it's...
I think I see what we can make with...
Still pretty decent.
Looks like a dud.
Fuck.
It happens.
Whatever. Okay, so yeah, that's kind of an example of how that works. So let's go and equip the new one that we just equipped. We can get rid of the HP overflow. Damage down. No, I want our knockback defense. Yeah, there we go. Damage down, knockback defense. There we go. Now our Prime is a little bit more of a wall. So let's get back in there, shall we? Actually, no. Let's upgrade some of his stats. Because you can also upgrade your character stats. Yeah, Optimus Prime here is fairly balanced right now. But we're going to make him even stronger. Stronger than ever before. Yeah, look at that. We're getting him up there. And we've immediately run out of money. Alrighty, so... whatever. Let's go! I point all the time. I'm surprised I haven't poked the cameraman's eye out because of that. He is only human, right? Or do we have a camera operator from Cybertron? Do we have our own laser beak? Probably not. My Optimus Prime impersonation is terrible. Oh god!
Not that I'm complaining.
Strange. They don't seem to notice us. There's something different about these Insecticons.
Yeah, that seems to be a new series thing. Before the Insecticons were... there weren't many of them. but in these later series, they're all over the damn place. I guess that has to do with just kind of the expanded lore and stuff, because, you know, as good as G1 was, at the same time, a lot of it was just kind of strung together. A lot of the actual development of the series and, like, its lore proper came later with stuff like Beast Wars and comic books. And later incarnations of the series, including, like, the Cybertron games and the Transformers Prime and all that fun stuff. So a lot of those things also kind of help build on the lore of the series and kind of help define some of these characters a little bit better. And I do think that some of those retcons are for the better, like the way the Dinobots, for example, in the G1 series were made is a little silly, but in Fall of Cybertron, they actually tell a different story about how the Dinobots were created, and I actually thought that it was pretty cool. So, just goes to show that some story changes are for the better, especially when those story changes actually make a lot more sense when you actually think about the grand scheme of things. Damn laser. Pop! Pop!
You're mine, or a jerk!
Oh god. Constructicons!
See how you Autobots look on my hook!
Shut up! We got Hook and Scrapper! Woo! Huh! You want to touch me? Too slow. What victory? I'm beating you up! I mean, sure, you actually did get a couple of good hits in there, but fuck you. Ugh. Just gonna fucking pepper you with missiles, because why not? Ugh. And you're fucking done. Nope! Sorry to disappoint you, bro. But you're done. Missile to the face.
Disengaging the first sub-generator now.
Man. I wish we had Basketball and Cybertron? Man, that would be cool. Maybe once we rebuild the planet, we'll introduce the sport. Maybe we'll even bring it here and entertain the humans. After all, the humans technically know about us in the G1 series. I mean, we originally tried to be discreet, but it wasn't really long until, like, everyone knew about us. In fact, there was actually a point where, there was actually an episode where, they made it a holiday about the Autobots. It was just straight up called Autobot Day. Oh shit, I accidentally broke Basketball. Sorry, humans. I'm sure that wasn't the only one there. In fact, there is another one over there. Okay, you're good. You guys can use this one as like a, I don't know, you guys like wrestling and stuff. All right. That terrible joke is done. Let's go. Don't go that way. Go this way. Avoid the lasers. You don't really get anything for getting rid of those claws, really.
Keep trying.
Except maybe experience. Oh, but you know what also helps? Actually going the right way. Which was... No, wait, no. I am going the correct way. just kind of didn't look like that for a second. Because the right way is this way. That's why. So you can pretty much go to these things in whatever order you want. Ignoring that fodder, we don't need to deal with him. We just want to get to the damn generators. Damn snipers. Go away! Thank you. Thank you for dying. Christ. Grim Zeke? I forget if I can collect you. Or if I shoot you. I know that there is something that I can do with you. Oh. There we go. Caught a Grim Zeke! Unlock new stage art. Yeah, Grim Zekes were like weird little energy sprite things that existed in G1. I kind of forget what they did. I think they could short out the bots. I'm not sure. I actually forget what Grim Zekes do, but I do remember seeing them in G1 before. I remember them being kind of weird. Here comes the second generator.
How strong your steel, Autobots, and how quick the conquest.
Mixmaster and Long Haul.
Surrender, Decepticons. This is your only warning.
You know what? In fact, screw this. I'm breaking out my hammer. I'm like Thor now. Bitch.
You'll have to do better
than that. Yeah. Now I'm going to go back to my axe. I actually do like the axe better. That weapon is a little too slow. Alright, let's do this combo. Woo, 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 woo!
Not even close.
Boom! I'm guessing. Oh god, he's starting to release goop at us. Oh Jesus, we don't want to touch any of that. Mixmaster is a master at chemical warfare. There is a reason why he's a mixing truck. I'm pretty sure that he has some mixed opinions about being dead as well as his buddy over there.
Shut down the sub-generator.
Why are all of these generators near, like, sports parks? The first one was near a basketball field, and, like, this one is, this one's, like, in a tennis court. The
primary generator is exposed.
Man, this actually kind of looks like one of those street playmats that you would see in kindergarten or, like, early grade school. I mean, look at this. It's kind of unreal. But yeah, all these things so far have been near sports arenas. Like, not sports arenas, but, like, just little, like, public little sports areas. Like, this is a tennis court. Before, there was a basketball court. So I'm going to imagine that the next one's going to be near a baseball ring or something. A baseball diamond or something. Guess we'll see. I actually forget if it is or not. Let's be cool and evade all this shit and boom. It's like hyperspace in Star Fox 64. It's like Sector X. Only you don't have to worry about breaking your fucking wings.
I'm going to take your brain.
Oh, be quiet, scavenger. Yeah, see, I know who you are. I've watched the show. Oh my god!
I've been itching for a fight.
Forget about Bone Crusher. Ouch. Whatever, we know the drill. And part of that drill is actually dodging on point. Wow. There we are. Take that, ow. Shit, we died. There's a first. Guess it was bound to happen. Don't get so careless next time, Gamma. Come on, you're better than this. You're way better than this. This feels really good, though. Despite the fact that the combo system is actually pretty damn simple. You could even break into a vehicle combo while firing. That's actually something that I kind of forgot about completely. If you want to learn how to talk to a Prime, ask your mom. I'm just gonna keep making him act like Bayonetta sometimes. I'm fighting back! What the fuck are you talking about? You're fucking done! Yeah, let's see if we can throw something at him. Ah! I got pounded into the ground? Oh god. He's drilling. Hey, freak! Take that! Hells yeah!
You'll have to do better than that!
Uh-oh. Drive! Hey! Don't fucking dodge me! Eat missiles, you fucker! I'm surprised that Megatron hasn't drilled it into your head that in order to win, you actually have to not suck.
Now to shut down the primary generator.
Alright, so this sub-generator was located in a generic-ass parking lot. I guess parking lot soccer could possibly be a thing that you can play here. Just set up a couple of nets. Yeah. That's what this is. This is a parking lot that sometimes people use as a soccer field, because all the other generators that we've seen so far have been in places where people can recreationally just kind of play sports. Also, ouch.
Time to vroom. Oh, hey, I didn't go the right way. And I'm breaking more of the sports. Shit. Anybody remember that April Fool's joke that IGN posted a couple years ago about Titanfall? And how apparently Optimus Prime was coming to it? I remember that. I enjoyed it. Screw that, I can walk past the lasers! I don't need to drive, I'm a robot. I went completely the wrong way. It told me to go that way, though. What the fuck? Oh well, whatever. Take that! I probably would have felt a lot better if I could actually drive through all of you, but whatever, we can't have everything. Take that, all of you deceptive bastards! Oh! Let's just jump up here and see if we can attack them. Whoa! Out of energy. Oh wait, I'm using my hammer. Okay, I don't want to use the hammer. I thought I would like the hammer better than I do. And now I'm out of energy for that, so I've got to do something quick. Oh wait, I got more ammo, somehow. Whatever, it's all good. And those missiles are just kinda gonna go somewhere. Shit, that may have actually been potentially catastrophic. It's probably gonna, like, kill some people. It's probably gonna ruin someone's day. That's why you gotta check your targets. More stuff! Eh. Hells yeah. Alright, let's just keep on rolling, baby. Knocking over every single car that ever was. I'm getting confused by this map. Yeah, it fucking keeps changing. I'm trying to follow you as best as I can, but you keep moving! Why? Ugh. I'm going to imagine it wants me to go this way. Yes, there we are. This is looking a bit more right. Cars never do this. Cars never just jump up onto building rooftops. Just saying. Don't want to deal with you fuckers right now. Oh, that was nice, except I missed that last one. Oh well. I dodged too soon. Screw you, Deceptive Snipers. I don't need to deal with you. I'm Optimus fucking Prime.
No one gets by the Constructicons.
Oh boy. Here we go again. Of course, you're gonna form Devastator. There's a weird part of me that likes the fact that the actual cutscenes are in 30 frames, just because it almost kind of gives it more of the animated kind of feel. Hey, Devastator, remember this? Huh. Okay, that didn't do as much damage this time. Shit.
This will hurt.
Oh dear. Oh, that's intimidating. He just made his hands into drills. That's not good. Oh! Damn it! Whoa! Not this time, buddy. Whatever, we've almost got him. Of course, he's almost got us, so should really be trying to look for any destructibles, because destructibles tend to have health. Oh my god. Oh, that was bad. I probably should have just stood my ground there. I was trying to see if there was anything that I could use as health, but no. It's not what this is about. Whatever, the checkpoints are generous as fuck, so it's like, whatever. Damn it, Devastator! This is only the beginning. This is the beginning of prime time. Ow. Ow. Gotta make use of that. Gotta take advantage of the fact that you can actually attack while driving. Like so. Especially when you have a lock-on weapon like the missiles. It all doesn't really help when you're actually dead. So let's try that again and actually not be careless. I know I said that before, but this time I actually mean it. Let's actually hurt him to the point where he falls over and dies. And we don't have to see him until at a later point in the game, because let's face it, it is called Transformers Devastation. He is like at the center of the cover. So I imagine that this ain't the last time we're gonna see him, right? Logic dictates that, right? It's chaos, I can't see what I'm doing, but whatever. He's getting closer to the dead.
This is your end!
I was kind of hoping that the dodge would work. Okay, now I'm just doing terribly. Holy shit. Come on. This is the last time, Devastator. That fucking hurt. Ow. Don't put me on face level with you. That's only gonna make your day even worse. At least now I'm just chipping at your feet. I am an army! I am Optimus Prime! Bitch! Shit! Must be more careful. No! Okay, come on. Last time for real. Yes, now we're doing much better. Now that we're actually just, like, not trying to be fancy, we're doing good. Should probably, make a note of this. Yeah, see, as soon as I start doing stuff like that, he just stomps on me, so... whatever. Whatever. He's done now. We just fucking trailer smacked him. In the soul, in the spark, even though that was his foot.
Greetings from beneath the earth, Autobots. As you can see, I am now in control of the greatest Cybertronian mission ever undertaken.
What?
It cannot be. The Proud Star.
And finally, the Diodes tumble. I am simply going to hasten the Insecticons' mission, instead of just cyberforming this city. With me at the helm, the entire planet will be transformed in mere days.
You plan to cyberform Earth?
Let me correct you, Optimus Prime. I don't plan to do anything. I have already started.
But the Earthlings...
will die!
Classic Megatron. Freaking classic. Oh, man. Oh, that's finally it for Chapter 1, City of Steel. So, I guess that means... oh, yeah, look at that. Look. Oh, we've actually missed a couple of the... yeah, there are some secret challenge areas. I'm kind of ignoring them, I know. I am mediocre at this. I don't care. I got a C rank overall. It's whatever. But yes, that was Chapter 1 of Transformers Devastation. Look at all that stuff we grabbed. What's going to happen next, I wonder? Will Megatron be able to succeed in cyberforming the entire planet? Will the Autobots be able to stop them? Which character will we play as next? There's only one way to find out, and that's to tune into the next exciting episode of Let's Play Transformers Devastation. Till then, take care.